Bingo, we're back with the 11 o'clock rock. You like my hat? It's a Boy Scouts hat. It was given to me by our esteemed guests today, Neal Atebara, MD. He is a member of the board of directors, and he's the chairman of Onizuka Day at the Boy Scouts Aloha Council. Welcome, Neal.
Thank you, Jay.
Great to see you again, always.
Good to see you
every
always.
Time.
Thank you.
Okay, and Jeff Sulzbach, he is the Scout Executive and CEO of the Aloha Council, Boy Scouts of America. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Great to have you guys.
Yeah, thank you.
So much is going on with the Boy Scouts. But first, a word. Boy Scouts established nationally, right?
Right.
In 1910.
Yeah, 107 years ago.
Okay, and Aloha Council established right after that.
Yeah.
Right, same year.
So October 1910. We've been here for 107 years.
Yeah, so this was one of the original chapters of the Boy Scouts.
Yeah, very early. Right?
Why was that? Yeah. What happened in Hawaii that made it, you know, jump on the bandwagon, so, like an early adopter, if you will?
A local artist, Howard Hitchcock, who was at the time an art instructor at Punahou School. He was in California. He saw Boy Scouts. He said, this is fantastic. He brought it back here to Hawaii, and it started here that same year. The Rainbow Patrol was the name of the first group of scouts.
Perfect.
At Punahou.
Yeah, so many wars later, so much has happened, and still, the Boy Scouts, totally relevant. As a matter of fact, I was thinking about it on the way in, and I have decided, and I'll throw this out for your consideration, the Boy Scouts is becoming more relevant now.
Absolutely.
Because of the way the social structure is working here and on the mainland, the way the schools are working, the way the connection between the parents and the schools and the latchkey problem and all that, we need the Boy Scouts for that kind of structure. This gives kids the opportunity to find themselves in a way that perhaps other structures in their lives don't allow them to do that. Neal, do you agree?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Scouting has always been about developing leadership, developing good character. And you often think about scouts as being hikers and campers and doing good deeds, and they certainly do that. But it's really all about character, and now we're really getting into STEM. STEM's another challenge, a cognitive challenge that helps youngsters bring out character within themselves.
And STEM is so important, and if Boy Scouts can be a connection to STEM, this is critical, not only for them, for their generation or generations, because there are more than one generation to the Boy Scouts, but it's also for the country and for the state. We need STEM. Now, Neal is very active in the Academy of Science, and therefore the science fair coming up in April.
Mm-hmm.
And so he can talk about STEM as few people can. And so, in fact, he was a hero in the Academy for Science, Science Fair, and it made him, may I say, some of it, maybe more of it than you like to think, made him what he is today, right?
Yeah. Science Fair and Boy Scouts played a big role in who I am today. The Science Fair was an opportunity to really kind of compete on a state level. I came from Hilo on a big island, which is, you know, not exactly a grand stage. And from the state science fair, I went to the international science fair. So that was a lot of fun. Boy Scouts has been part of my life, you know, from very early on, probably when I was 6 years
old. Let me guess, you were a Boy Scout.
I was a Boy Scout, and Jeff is a Boy Scout. We're both Boy Scouts. We're Eagle Scouts, once an Eagle, always an Eagle. And it's I think always kept me on track as far as you know, doing the right thing, trying to give back to the community. It's been, you know, a huge part of my life.
It's no accident that you guys were both Scouts. You were an Eagle Scout too, I guess.
Yeah,
right?
I am an Eagle Scout. We like to say, right?
Oh, that's right. That's defines right. you forever, doesn't
that's
it?
That's it.
Yeah. And so you know, you remain loyal. It's like the guys who go to Yale. They remain loyal, or Princeton.
Go Bulldogs.
it's for their whole lives. So that's a gift, you know, that you don't find too often. The fact is, these kids go through this program, and it defines them for life.
Yeah,
this is a fabulous thing.
It's interesting. It's an award that most people earn before they turn 18. All people do before they turn 18. You know, 15, 16, 17 years old, and yet you carry it throughout your life, which is a pretty significant accomplishment to follow you through your life.
Yeah.
Even when I'm applying to medical school and even residency after that, you don't put anything from high school on there, but they actually still ask, even though it's not on the resume, they ask, oh, so were you a Boy Scout? And they say, oh, were you an Eagle Scout? And I think they talk to you a little bit different, a little bit more respect there.
I agree. I think absolutely. I mean, it stops you in your tracks. Eagle Scout, oh, that is something. And when I grew up, I went to summer camp in New York State. Mm-hmm. And right next door was a place called 10 Mile River.
Right.
huge Boy Scout camp, huge, and it was so well respected. Mm-hmm. You know, all you had to do was say, I've been at 10 Mile River, you know, because it was that good. And they made Eagle Scouts there mm-hmm. tough. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I mean, I think every kid ought to have the benefit. That's mm-hmm. what I think.
Yeah.
Because in our society, they need it, and if it's available, their parents should, you know, take them down to the Boy Scout.
And we're working hard to get every kid the opportunity mm-hmm. to be a Boy Scout, to be involved in the community through the scouting program, and we're going to talk to you a little bit more about how we can bring scouting to more young people.
Yeah, let's do that. Yeah. Let's talk about some of the things that are coming up. For example, on April 29th, you have a program. What is that program? That's at the Blaisdell. That's 300,000 or 400,000 people coming down.
It's going to be huge. It's going to be totally huge.
we're expecting 3,000 or 4,000 people. It's a STEM family fun event called the Onizuka Day of Exploration. It's named after the famous Ellison. Eagle Scout Ellison Onizuka.
Of course,
from Kealakekua on the Big Island, who flew on the spaceship.
Neal's from the Big Island.
That was a subtle plug for the Big Island. So we're naming this event after him. The original name is the Scout Makahiki, which has been around since 1911, and it's actually the oldest continuously running Scout event in the country.
Makahiki is just Hawaii.
Yes,
Makahiki, a Hawaii
it's
word.
Just Hawaii, yeah.
But it's so famous, the word Makahiki.
Yeah, you know, back then, I mean, back when we were Scouts, it was. There's only one Makahiki. It was a Scout Makahiki. And today there's lots of organizations that call things Makahiki. And that's one of the reasons why we're changing the name, at least to the public, and also to give it the STEM theme. So it's going to be for the entire community. So we're really changing it to be a community event. We want everybody from the community to come. We're going to have lots of things. We're going to have 22 hands-on STEM activities led by science experts from around the state.
Science things, so science exhibits things. And experiments and explanations?
They're going to be workshops. You're going to learn how to do DNA electrophoresis, dissect a mammalian heart.
Wow.
Learn how to deploy parachutes, building electric motors.
This is great.
Yeah, pretty wild stuff. And we're going to have professors from UH, from Chaminade, from Iolani School. So that's one component. It'll be 22 workshops. And it's open to the public, and it's free.
Okay.
Another component is that there's going to be 60 science activity stations. And these are going to be run by the Scouts. So they're going to have their...
Sounds like a science fair.
Well, there's a similarity there.
Okay,
yeah.
All right.
But it's going to be more like with a Scout bent. It's going to be hands-on. You know, it's going to be using everyday kind of things to make something really cool. So things lying around the house to build an electric motor, to make a light bulb. Do you know you can make a light bulb with pencil lead?
I have, I have to be there to see this.
And it lights up.
Yeah.
We'll have balloon hovercrafts and my troop's going to make this thing called an augmented reality sandbox. Have you ever seen that? This thing is so cool. And it's regular sand, you play with it, and there's a projector up on top, and it scans the topology, and then it projects a real-time image on it. So it'll show you where the high points are, where the low points are. Uh-huh. And the low points, it'll like fill with water. And you move the sand around and the water would...
Oh, I have seen this. Yeah, this is really impressive.
It's really cool.
Yeah,
really cool. So there's going to be stuff like that. Plus, there's going to be an elevated ropes course. There's going to be two climbing walls. There's going to be a robotics competition, Lego car race, food, and Mr. Jake the Wizard, who is this amazing educator and science advisor. He's been on Jay Leno's Tonight Show. He's been on the Discovery Channel, Mythbusters.
Jake the Wizard.
Yeah,
Can you send him to me? I want to interview him right here.
Oh,
at
you
table,
should. You should. Yeah. I've seen him. He'll blow up this table in front of you. Wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah. For a moment it would.
Yeah.
You know, with Neal on your board and with Neal working as the chair of the Ellison
Onizuka.
You know, program here on April 29th. What's left for you to do, Jeff?
I'm the head cheerleader. I am the cheerleader right now. I'm here to support a great group of volunteers. There's a group of about 20 volunteers who've gotten together to work on this. Some of them are board members. Mm-hmm. Some are coming from our troops and our PACs. But they're all working together, and that will cascade out amongst all of our PACs and troops across the island of Oahu to take this on and make this a day for the community. And we see it as a community service opportunity. So not only is it our Scout Makahiki kind of being reinvented, but it's also an opportunity for us to reach out to the community and say, come on in, learn about science, learn about STEM, and become a scout for a day. And hopefully, just hopefully,
it'll stick.
That's exactly right.
Yeah, that's
in fact,
great.
One of our little opportunities inside the Blaisdell is to have a model campsite, which isn't really a campsite, we're calling it the space station. And they'll go through five or six different scout type activities as a part of that space station. Most of them are STEM themed as well. And at the end, they'll have a chance to learn more about the scouting and how to become part of that.
Well, that raises a whole issue about scouts engaging with each other, being in peer groups, learning from each other, forming teams to do, you know, collaborative mm-hmm. effort, mm-hmm. and getting out in the outdoors,
yeah.
which I'm afraid to say that, you know, in our day, I say our day, I'm lumping up the generations, in our day, we got out in the outdoors more than it seems to me that a lot of people get out in the outdoors now, especially in Hawaii, where we have outdoors, you know. And after we come back from this break, I would like to discuss with you, you know, the general activities that the Scouts
sure.
do and how that works in terms of the engagement, the activities, and the ordinary course. That is when you're not having Ellis and Okazuka Day, mm-hmm. Onizuka Day. Right?
Great.
Okay, we'll be right back.
Good.
I pity the fool who ain't watching this show at 12 o'clock on Friday afternoon. Stan, the Energy Man, watch it.
I'm Ethan Allen, host of Likeable Science here on ThinkTech Hawaii. Every Friday afternoon at 2 p.m., you'll have a chance to come and listen and learn from scientists around the world. Scientists who talk about their work in meaningful, easy-to-understand ways. And you'll come to appreciate science as a wonderful way of thinking, way of knowing about the world. You'll learn interesting facts, interesting ideas. You'll be stimulated to think more. Please come join us every Friday afternoon at 2 p.m. here on ThinkTech Hawaii for Likeable Science with me, your host, Ethan Allen.
Okay, we're back. We're live. Neal Atebara and Jeff with Sulzbach. You know, the breaks, you know, sometimes the best part of our show.
Right.
And we're talking about how you guys are building that special generation and how Neal is bringing something special to it that he has had years of experience with, not only as a scout, but as an organizer of the science fair. So can you talk about the generation you're trying to build here in Hawaii?
Sure.
And how that relates to the future of them and our state?
Yeah, so, you know, the current generation of young people, right before the break we talked about, you know, what are they doing today? What are they interested in? Are they getting outside? Are they getting away from their screens and all that type of thing that, you know, we're all concerned about as parents and as community leaders? Scouting still does all that. The outdoors, we think, is still the best classroom for young people. It really pushes them into the elements and forces them to confront things that they maybe don't confront otherwise. You have to live with consequences when you're outdoors. Decisions you make are decisions that you're going to have to live with. And that builds leadership, it builds character, builds perseverance in young people, which is all part of what scouting does through the program day in, day out. That said, 30% of all of our merit badges today, and there's over 100 merit badges, are science related. And so science and STEM is really a core part of the scouting program. It always has been. We're just taking it kind of a new direction as we reinvent our Makahiki.
Yeah, well, that's great. And I remember, you know, I have a godson who went through the Scouts, and he was an Eagle Scout, too, here in Hawaii. Mm-hmm. And, boy, I went to that ceremony where they invested him as an Eagle Scout, and I saw these 100 merit badges. I couldn't believe it, all these really sophisticated things. You know, some of them are college credit courses
yeah.
kinds of things. Some of the things you mentioned, you know, as the exhibits in the Makahiki. And I said to myself, gee, this is great value. This is like school, but it's easy. In, you know, in terms of you know, finding comfort with it, and learning can be fun, and getting outdoors, and having your buddies do it with you, and all that stuff. So, you know, to me, this is really critically important to bringing people together in a world that might otherwise isolate them. You know, I don't think Hawaii is different from other places. Kids become isolated, and what we can do that's special is to gather and bring them together and let them learn from each other and give them value, nutrition, which is what you guys are doing. And that's relevant just as it was in 1910.
One of the great things that Neal mentioned, our event on April 29th, we'll have over 2,000 scouts and families there as part of the scouting community. They come from all over the island. So they come from right here in Honolulu. They come from the Waianae coast. They come from up on the North Shore, from all over the island, coming together. They're going to look kind of similar. They're going to be in their scout t-shirts, or they'll be in their scout uniforms.
How about the red hats?
Some will have red hats here. Okay. That's right. Yeah. And so you won't know where they're from when you see them, because they're all going to be scouts there in the room, coming together for a common purpose and learning together. It's great.
So did you need to reinvent? I mean, you're talking about reinventing the Makahiki. I mean, that's been going on, as you said, a long, long time from the beginning. How was it doing before you reinvented it? Was there a need to evolve it in a special way?
It's a great question. In 2010, we took a shift from having the, for a while, the Makahiki was actually done in a campsite. It was done off by itself, and we said, you know what, 2010 is a centennial anniversary for Boy Scouts. Let's go out into the community and bring the community, you know, to scouting. But we didn't really know how to do that, because we were really still doing kind of the same old thing, which was more inward focused. It was scouts getting together, challenging each other, doing different types of competitions, but how do we actually reach out and bring the community into the program? We weren't sure how to do that at the time, so this is one way we're doing that. We want to stay relevant. I think that's really important to us, that we're relevant, and we want to really find a way that people can approach scouting in a way that maybe they're not used to. As Neal said, you know, they're used to seeing scouts hiking, camping, doing community service. Those are all things that scouts do, but what else do scouts do? And we're going to show them.
Yeah. Well, you know, I was thinking as you were describing this that in this country, in the sort of the opening of the West, there were these great gatherings between the settlers and the cattlemen. And remember, way back when, you know, in the days of Lewis and Clark, and they got together every now and then in an open clearing. And so this was part of the rich culture of finding the West. And I think when the Boy Scouts were established, this was had to be Makahiki and kind of gathering like that had to be part. It had to be an extension of what was going on in the country. So it's really deep roots is what it is, and very valuable to see it play. And it's completely still, to me, totally relevant. In fact, it's something we have to look back to. You know, we can't forget our own history, especially in a case where it's been successful the way it's been for you. So when they get together, what kinds of things do they do customarily now before the evolution?
Sure.
What were they doing, and what you know, were they not including science then?
Oh, some of them were, but it was, I think, more it was there were two types of activities. Some of it was more like carnival type activities where they're actually doing different types of games and competitions. Some of it was showing scout skills, everything from fire building and knot tying. We had in the past Makahikis, we've had some historic Hawaiian games where things like throwing, you know, rolling the rocks and things like that, that were historic games that were part of Hawaiian tradition. So those are all things we brought forth to the Makahiki. Science, not so much. That wasn't things that we really were focusing on.
So that's the new element.
That's the new element, yeah.
Oh, that's fabulous. Yeah. So you got to have a guy like Neal for sure.
Absolutely.
But tell me about your board. Tell me about your executive. Tell me about your staff. How does it work? Where are they from? What do they study? What do they bring to you?
Yeah, so our board of directors, there's 60 people on the board, so we've got a big group.
60.
They represent most walks of life throughout our community here in Hawaii. We have people from each of the islands that are part of our board of directors. We have attorneys, we have business people, we have people that are working, we have parents. So the board is really a diverse group of people. Doctors on the board, so you name it, that's part of our board. Their job is to provide stewardship, to provide governance and leadership, and to give direction. And Neal is one of the board members who picked up and said, here's an area where I can contribute and give direction.
Right, oh, perfect choice.
Yeah.
Good work.
Yeah.
But so you're looking for people who can help in certain areas.
Absolutely.
On the
always.
Board.
Yeah, yeah, always.
How about your staff? Where do you get them from? What is their training? What is their background? I mean, in general.
Yeah, I'd say our staff today are about half alumni of the scouting program. So about half of them were scouts themselves, some Eagle Scouts, some not. The other half are people who are interested in young people and really, you know, helping to nurture the next generation and bring them forward and into adulthood.
Are they engaged? They come out?
Yeah.
Are they going to be there?
They'll
at
be
the
there. They'll all be there, absolutely. They'll be there 100%.
Yeah, that's great. So, you know, Neal, what's it like for you? You put a lot of time in. Do you fundraise? Do you fundraise for the Boy Scouts?
Yeah, do that.
Because I know you're good at that. Tell me how you handle that kind of thing, and what it's like being on the board. What it's like being the chair of the Onizuka Makahiki.
Well, it's a great privilege to be on the board. I mean, it's I see it from a whole different perspective. You know, I've been in the scouting program as a youngster, gone all the way through, and I see it from that aspect. And it was fascinating to me that the work that the board does is largely transparent, or actually largely invisible, from a scout perspective. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the way it should be. Mm-hmm. You know, scouts should just go out, have fun, learn as they go along, and maybe not even realize it, but not have to worry about things like fundraising or things like organizing on a broader level. But on as a parent and as a leader in my troop and as a board member, now I see it from a different aspect, and it's more challenging in some ways, but it's definitely more gratifying. I think I actually get more out of scouting as an adult than as when I was as a youngster, mm-hmm. because I can interact with my two sons.
Who are both scouts?
They're both,
and the troop you mentioned is their troop.
That's right. Okay. Right. 325.
325. Shout out to 325.
and I get to interact with their friends. You know, I think I would not have been able to understand the things that they go through and their peers if I weren't so actively. So I'd like to give a plug for being an adult leader too. Be a scout and also be an adult leader, because you get a lot out of it.
Yeah. Strikes me from what Neal says, you know, that as you alluded to in the first place, scouting is lifelong, and therefore it doesn't stop when you sort of take the uniform off, when you finish the program, so to speak, being an Eagle Scout, all that, that it plays out in the community. So if, for example, I want to form a partnership, and a fellow on the other side of the table says, I'm an Eagle Scout, and I say, I'm an Eagle Scout, there's more chance that I'm going to have a good partnership with that.
You bet.
And I'm going to be more likely to cut a deal with him, to trust him, and so forth, because we have this common denominator. We both came up through the same process, have the same exposure to these values. But, can we say that putting a kid through the Scouts program enriches our business community in Hawaii? Does the Scouts have an influence in the business community?
Yeah, no
and
question
if so,
about
how?
It.
How, yeah. how is that?
Yeah, no question about it. I think the relationships that you brought up is a key component of that. And, Hawaii is a very relational type of place.
Right.
That the relationships are strong, they're deep. Being a scout is another connection. And when you get a group of scouts together, whether they're Eagle Scouts or not, they'll talk about where was their troop, where did they grow up, and how do they actually get through that process. And that's a common thing we all can share together.
Yeah.
By the way, this Friday night, our Eagle Scout alumni group is getting together. They're going to have a gathering at Oahu
all
Country
ages.
Club. Yeah, all
John
ages.
Henry Felix, right there.
We expect him to be there.
That chair last
he
year.
Is an Eagle Scout, one of our distinguished alumni, absolutely.
Yes.
You bet. Oahu Country Club, Friday night, starting at 4 o'clock. We're having a little barbecue there. Very informal, a chance to have our alumni come together, share some old stories, and hopefully form those bonds that can help them in their professional lives, too.
Yeah, these are formative years when kids are scouts, and they carry that all through and remain connected. It's like an alumni association. Well, that is what it's called, yeah.
You bet.
Alumni association, yeah. Like from a school that you really like to go
to. That's right, that's
right. And you always have that bond going forward.
I think there's a lot of organizations that focus on community and leadership, even sports. But the unique thing about scouting, I think, is that that's the main purpose for meeting is to help build character in our youngsters. That's actually the only reason that we're meeting. So I was talking to parents who have kids who are thinking about joining scouting, and I tell them that when they start for Boy Scouts, and when they start, they're definitely boys, but when they end, they are young men.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of things that happen in that crucial time period.
Yeah.
And it's a good time for them to grow in a structured environment where we start every meeting saying that we're going to work on these things. We're going to work on being trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and those are 12 things that we're going to work on every time we meet.
Exactly what kids need. And so often they don't get that, and if we're going to hold our society together, we need lots of people who hold those values, who have that structure. But I want to ask you one more thing. On the way in also, I was listening to a story about the current thinking in the military. about how they organize their efforts these days in small groups, mm-hmm. maybe larger groups. And one of the things is they want to be smart. And one of the things is whatever they do, they learn by it. They have a special kind of procedure now. Whatever mission they go on, when they come back, they talk about it. Mm-hmm. What did we do right? What did we not do right? What do we have to do better next time?
Yeah.
So you guys are going into the Makahiki, April 29th at Blaisdell. I get that right?
Mm-hmm. April 29th at Blaisdell.
Okay. So you're going to be looking for, you know, new things to learn in this new model of the Makahiki. What do you be looking for? What do you hope to learn about making it even better in 2018?
Well, I think the main thing is we want to engage the community. We want the community to come, see what scouting is like, have a good time, learn some STEM, and if they like what they see, they might even consider joining. Secondly, we want our scouts an opportunity to serve. We want them to
serve the community.
Serve the community. They want to, because that's a huge part of what being a scout is, to selflessly serve without thinking of reward. And that's a lesson that we want to be integral with the scouts' activities in this.
Working for the common good.
Yeah.
We absolutely have to have that. Mm-hmm. You know, ThinkTech believes in that so deeply.
Right.
And
right.
That, and to, you know, survive as a robust, healthy society, which Hawaii has the possibility of doing, if we all work for the common good, you know, we'll all be better off, every man, woman, child. And the Boy Scouts are doing just that.
That's scouting at the core, right there. It's working as a team. Scouting, every level of scouting, it's always team-oriented. We call them dens or patrols, working together for a common good.
So if I wanted to join, if I wanted to find out more about the Makahiki, Ellison Onizuka Makahiki this year, April 29th, the Blaisdell, where would I go? Where would I look?
Scouting.
How could I join?
Yeah, our website, scoutinghawaii.org. Real simple, scoutinghawaii.org.
Yeah, I can remember that. Yeah. Scoutinghawaii.org. There you go.
Yeah, that's it.
Closing words?
Well, thank you for having us on there, Jay. It's always a pleasure.
Thank you, Neal. Neal Atebara, MD, and the chair of the Ellison Onizuka Makahiki this year, 2017. And Jeff Sulzbach, the executive of the Boy Scouts Council.
Aloha Council.
Boy Scouts of America right here.
Join us on April 29th. It's free. It's for families. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Come down, watch it.